Nigerian Foreign Affairs Minister Geoffrey Onyema arrived in Tunis on Wednesday for a two-day official visit. He met with Tunisian President Beji Caid Sipsi at Carthage Palace, where they discussed ways of boosting bilateral ties. It is the first visit in 30 years by a Nigerian senior level official.
We face similar economic challenges, and therefore we have identified areas where we feel that the two countries can really achieve real concrete deliverables. Education, health, in the area of infrastructure development, ICT, information and communications technologies, renewable energies. We even talked about the mutual assistance and training of our diplomats.
The Nigerian Foreign Minister said that Nigeria, Tunisia and all African countries could benefit from each other's experience by facilitating cooperation and supporting each other's claims and projects in the continent.
We also looked at our joint roles at the sub-regional level. Tunisia has applied, and we supported very much that application for an observer status of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS. It'll be a win-win situation. We'll increase the market access of Tunisia to the West African market, and give an opportunity also for West African countries to also benefit from those areas and sectors in which Tunisia has a real comparative advantage.
The war on terror and the security in Africa were also on the agenda of the meeting.
The threat of terror is an existential threat for Tunisia, Nigeria, and other African states. It is clear that the only way we can overcome this is by working closely together. This is what we're planning to do by sharing intelligence and other means of cooperation between our intelligence and security services.
Khmayis Jhinawi and his Nigerian counterpart insisted on putting an end to the war in Libya through more mediation efforts and dialogue.
We've discussed the situation in Libya. We've agreed to help our Libyan brothers to overcome their differences and to opt for a peaceful solution to the conflict in Libya.
At the continental level, the heads of the Tunisian and the Nigerian diplomacies identified some of the challenges facing the African Union. They agreed on the way forward in addressing those challenges. The statement of the presidency shed light on the importance of having a strong and independent African Union that responds to the needs of African countries.
The Nigerian Foreign Minister's visit to Tunisia heralds a new era of cooperation between the two countries. Analysts maintain that African leaders would do well to keep developing new partnerships in various sectors on the continent. Adnan Shoaishi, CGTN, Tunisia.